It's an engineering marvel.
For the past 3 years, they live life 150 feet in the air, 5 feet at a time.
We're just inching away here.
Working on the longest single activity of the Salt Lake Temple renovation project to date.
I've spent probably thousands of hours sitting behind this control panel at this point.
They are drillers and machinists, hundreds of miles away from home, laboring to make a safer Salt Lake Temple for future generations.
I feel honored to have my company and my crew as part of this project.
Although fulfilling, this crew will tell you, to a person, it's the toughest project of their careers.
There's so many challenges, but little by little, we overcame those challenges and it developed to a point where no matter what the building throws at us, we're prepared.
The task, drilling vertical holes down through historic exterior stone walls.
That are actually being drilled from the top of the spires all the way down right in between these jack and bore casings.
Like threading a needle, to be sure. A precision process called vertical coring uses hollow diamond-edged drill bits to core out the temple's granite-like stone.
This involved 2.5 miles of vertical coring through the structural walls of the historic temple. And that core comes all the way down past the historic foundation, past the girders, down to about isolator level.
It's an integral phase of constructing the base isolation system designed to preserve the temple in earthquakes. The corners of each of the towers and walls of the temple required these vertical holes. 46 holes had an average length of 150 feet deep that demanded undeviating accuracy.
This had to be done at ultra precision within 10 millimeters from the start point to the end point.
But the coring crew kept it to 8 millimeters. That's less than 3/8 of an inch leeway from top to bottom. The purpose, so post-tension cables like these can attach to the reinforced steel roof and towers at the top and to the newly constructed footings and transfer beams below.
The accuracy of these holes has to be very precise due to the requirements of the tension cables that will go in the holes.
The bundle of cables in each of the 46 holes are then pulled to a tension of 500,000 pounds.
When we activate those cables and pull them to their target load, they'll essentially sandwich the structure and provide a structural rigidity.
But getting there, a careful, methodical process requiring crucial equipment custom made for the Salt Lake Temple.
There's pretty much nothing off the shelf up here.
Like these bearing stabilizers that keep the coring process in alignment.
This doesn't exist in any other context and is not typically used in conventional coring.
Additionally, 4 specially modified and custom designed drills have populated the temple towers throughout the 3-year duration.
Its main function is to spin this drill string, which is essentially a series of heavy-duty pipes that run continuously down to the bottom of the hole.
The drills propel a downward thrust of 16,000 pounds to what is called a drill string. The string is comprised of a diamond-edged drill bit threaded to 5-foot sectioned hollowed rods, lengths critical in keeping the drill string on course.
We've learned is that within 5 feet, it will not deviate outside of our boundary.
The coring crew anticipated working with solid stone, but got an unwelcome surprise.
We thought we would be drilling pristine square blocks, and what we found was that we're drilling it, and sometimes in rubble.
Those voids in the walls can make the bit veer off course if not for vigilance and decisive action.
To drill perfectly straight, I've got to keep a close eye on probably 6 different parameters.
If the alignment deviates off center, approaching 8 millimeter, we have special tooling that makes it where we can steer the bit back to the center line.
Coring requires water to prevent overheating, but that had the potential for catastrophic damage to the historic structure.
We needed to be able to drill the holes almost dry because we can't be flooding the walls and having water and slurry infiltrating into the interior walls.
A low flow water system developed especially for the temple alleviated that problem. The waste slurry of stone dust and water is removed through an innovative vacuum and filter system that recycles the water.
We have a hose that is connected to the drill string that puts the inside of the string under a vacuum in order to recover slurry from the bottom of the hole.
It's a nonstop operation that demands another first on top of the temple, a fully equipped machine shop.
This machine shop is the lifeblood of this operation. It seems a little crazy to set a machine shop on top of the temple, but we needed this operation to be right next to where we're working.
Drills, rods, and core bits are kept in good repair. In fact, Lonnie has refurbished more than 700 core bits and fabricated dozens of custom tools and mechanisms to keep the job running smoothly.
This shop allows us the ability to make changes to our process on the fly. Sometimes we have to be pretty creative on how we do that.
The vertical coring crew, faced with a daunting task, adapted and overcame with ingenuity and sheer determination, leaving an indelible contribution to the Salt Lake Temple renovation project.
I'm proud to be part of this project, you know, on a historic building that means so much to so many people.
It's very rewarding to be part of making sure that this building will be around for many, many more decades.